Hey, this is Derek Jordan. Welcome to the World Fusion Show, where we bring you the leading innovators in world fusion music. Today, my guest is Paul Richmond, who is a performance poet and spoken word artist. He is a member of the group Do It Now, which includes frequent guests Tony Vacca from our show and also John Sheldon, and they also are world fusion artists. So Paul has a world fusion style that he's using now with his poetry. And he is the National Beat Poet Laureate, which we'll talk more about later. And he has 6 books of his poetry that are published. Welcome, Paul Richmond, to the World Fusion Show.
Eric, so great to be here. Thank you so much for having me on your show. And so, here I am.
Here you are, and here we go. So we're doing this is our first Zoom World Fusion show. Hopefully all will go smoothly. But I just wanted you to start, as we often do, just giving us a little bit, a glimpse of your background, growing up, and, you know, how you got into art, music, poetry, and, you know, all the stuff you're into.
Okay, great. So real quick snapshot was, is I was a kid that was brought up on sight reading, which was not a good idea, which meant that there were no phonics. So I could not say words. Dictionaries meant nothing to me because a W didn't mean anything besides looking at it. So I don't come from now being the beat poet laureate of someone who came from a literary place. I didn't read really well till 7th grade, but, you know, being in the American education system, you get pushed along. And so it took me a long time to sort of get to that, to where I was actually wanting to write. And I was inspired by writing because I was at the University of Buffalo, who had an amazing English department. So I got to see William Burroughs, Gary Snyder, a lot of the beat poets, because the English department was bringing them in. And I was teaching there. And because I was teaching, I went on the road during the summer, so I start writing myself. Funny enough, when I first tried to read on the road, I couldn't get it. I didn't really read it. And it's something about sometimes some books hit you when they hit you. Years later, pick it up and boom, you're through it. You read the whole thing. So from there of teaching and education and seeing, wanting people to have their voice, I actually went, and you could say, joined the circus once I stopped teaching because of the changes there without getting into all that. I became a juggler. It was a hobby that I took. I suddenly was professional for over 20 years. And so there I had to write a lot of my skits. I mean, when I went places, whatever my juggling tricks were, you know, of this and the tricks stayed the same, but the verbiage always changed depending on what I was getting hired for. So I was writing there in terms of doing that. That all stopped at some point after 22 years. And I had been writing a lot of stuff and stories, and I got asked to do a couple things. And so suddenly I start hitting the scene. There's a scene, like a music scene, a jazz scene, a club scene. There's a slam scene. There's poetry festivals. And luckily with the internet, I could find festivals all over the country, and I kept going to them. So I basically went to those. Being a juggler, you know, well, you know, as a performer, Derek, you know, writers, I think, aren't used to the idea that you have to promote yourself. They're writing, they're sending in. As a musician, if we don't call up or we don't make a postcard, a program thing, and send it to some festival, they don't come knocking on our doors. So that helped me in the sense that when I went to a writer, I took myself to Austin, I took myself to somewhere else. And I wanted to be in front of audiences that didn't know me so that I could really go, okay. So basically, that brought me to the present place. I did my own festivals, jumped real fast, and I created Do It Now, which we can get into later. And yep, I published 6 books now.
Actually, I think we're getting into it sooner rather than later. I'd love you to talk about this video that we're going to see, which is called Who Works for Who? I think that's the one. Yes, we're going to see that. So tell us a little about that.
Okay, so just a real quick introduction of this is Do It Now. Do It Now is something that I created. I asked Tony Vacca and John Sheldon, and at the time, Joe Salins, to perform with me at one of my festivals. And the project has morphed over the years because that's already 3-4 years ago. Various other musicians come in. We jumped in at one place to play. And this now is just a continuation. So this particular piece just has myself, Tony, and John in it. And it's my attempt to keep, asking relevant questions about what's been happening.
All right, cool. Let's go to the video right now.
Unidentified.
Federal agents.
Federal agents. Operating without accountability. How do we stop them? Who's gonna tell them? You can't kidnap people off the streets. I mean, where are the police? Why aren't the police stopping these kidnappings? Who works for who? Who works for who?
The people are in the streets. They want to change.
Stop the violence, the racism, the hoarding of wealth, stealing from the poor. Stop raping the earth and everyone on it.
2020 police brutality, police violence.
A civil rights violation. Excessive force, beatings, a cry for justice only brings more vicious beatings. Early records suggest labor strikes were the first large-scale incidences of police brutality in the United States. The events, the Great Railroad Strike of 1877, the Pullman Strike of 1894, the Lawrence Textile Strike of 1912, the Ludlow Massacre of 1914, the Great Steel Strike of 1919, and on and on and on. That's right, paid thugs now are dressed militarized. The PR machine for the military says it's given the military a bad name. Why is the military stopping them, protecting the people? I mean, who works for who? Forcing so many into poverty, desperate people are easy to control. Or are they? Or are they? Every camper knows, don't get in between a mother bear and her cub. Yes, the mothers came out, the dads, the youth were carrying the torch. A Bill of Rights, the First Amendment, freedom of speech, freedom of assembly. Congress didn't get the job done. They left on vacation. Millions have no money or work. People need food today. Today. You don't go on vacation for a month. I mean, who works for who? Who works for who?
Yes, we're in the street. Yes,
we're
in the
street. Yes, we're not going back. We need real change. We need real change. Who works for who? Who works for who? We need real change. We need real change.
All right, we are back with Paul Richmond, performance poet and spoken word artist and member of Do It Now. Paul, that was really cool. You really hit these issues hard. You know, I think it's great. We're going to just what you've done, a bunch of festivals you were talking about. And we're going to next talk about this next video, which is a performance, live performance of you in Senegal. So tell us a little bit about this.
Okay, so real quickly, I'm a publisher besides a writer, so I try to get other people's voices out. And in that, I create word stages. So I have a yearly big festival, and I have a stage at a regular big festival, is which I met Tony at one of those festivals. He has the Senegal American Project. And over the years of us working together, he asked me to go out. We went out this January for their big New Year's celebrations. This happened at the engagement place where they have a 650 seat outdoor theater. It's called the Theater of the Craze. It's worldwide. People come to this solo body to meet other performers and perform. And I got a chance to be on the stage, as you'll see, with many great Senegal artists who played. And it was really interesting just to see that we could get by the various word language stuff, because there was a lot about feel. You know, and you've been there, and the music there, people are, it's a gift. You're making offerings to the community. So it was great just to be there and try that.
It certainly was, I'm sure. And also many of the members of your band have had their own featured episodes on the World Fusion.
Yes, I was going to say, that's right. You could listen, you could spend a whole show just going through all the people you've had, which is really excellent to have them all in one place. And here we are.
There you were. Okay, let's go to the video right now.
Yeah, he's crossing the highway. He's walking along it, actually. And car after car after car is going by. Looking across to the other side. He wants to get to the other side, but the cars just keep going by. Car after car after car.
Crossing, crossing in the highway. Cars and cars. Cars
and cars. Everybody wants to get across, so he doesn't know what to do. He walks along. It's a large rock. And he holds it above his head, and he decides to step towards the first line of traffic. When he gets to the other
tried to sell rocks to tourists, but he ended up at his old corner with his old sign. He was a homeless vet. He would work for food. He would work for food. But if you need a rock, he's got one for you. Because he's the rock guy.
We are back with Paul Richmond. And Paul, you've done a bunch of, you know, interesting things, and you have this interesting award you won called the National Beat Poet Laureate, which is like, what the hell is that, right? Tell us what that's all about.
Let's see. Well, quick for anybody who wants to do things. I did not know about that organization because of my work that I was doing. They showed up at one of my festivals. I was first honored the Massachusetts Beat Poet Laureate for 2 years. And then following that, I was then given the U.S. Beat Poet Laureate. The virus, it took a little chunk out of me trying to be out there on the road with it. But, when you win these awards, still good to have that. I've been graced with, you know, performing nationally and internationally. That's how I got to Senegal. I got to go to Edinburgh. I performed there for 12 shows at the Fringe Festival. I made it to Sweden. There was a Beat Poet Festival there. I went to Hungary. You know, it's great meeting, as you have on your show, it's great meeting people from other places and that have the soul or the spirit that you are wondering about, because sometimes you may not even find it in your own hometown. And suddenly you go and there you are in, you know, Sweden, and two musicians come up and everybody's just on, and boom, you go. And you go, okay, wow, we all, you know, feel or believe the kind of same thing and want to express our art in the same way.
Yeah, yeah. So we're going to watch another video coming right up. This one is called Push the Button, and that's another one of your hard-edged, you know, it's like, you know, life in our current existential, whatever we're doing now, it captured that so beautifully. You want to say something about it?
Thank you very much. This is John Sheldon again and Tony Vacca on this one. It is a tricky thing, as you and I talked about, how to talk about things that are frustrating, not great experiences, and still add some irony or sarcasm or hope also in it, to be able to see a bigger picture, even though it's not, the present picture isn't good. So how do you, you know, step out of that? So I try that with these pieces.
Yeah. All right, let's go to the video right now.
Yeah, it's a parking garage. You know the routine. You pull up to the gate. You push the button, and a ticket arrives. I push the button, and there's no ticket. I push the button again, and there's still no ticket. I push it a little harder. I see there's other buttons. I'm pushing buttons, and I don't get a ticket. I read the easy instructions, and it tells me to push the button. So now I'm screaming and pushing buttons. And over the loudspeaker, a voice comes on and says, "Hi, I'm Charlie. Do you need some help?" And I say, "Charlie, I'm pushing buttons. and I'm not getting any ticket. And so I push the button again just to show him I know where the button is, and so he can see that I don't get a ticket. I said, Charlie, it's one of those days you push buttons and nothing happens. He said, yeah, tell me about it. That's my life in a nutshell. And I say, I'm really sorry, Charlie. Anything I can do for you? He said, thanks for asking. Nobody usually asks me what they can do for me. I say, well, anything I can do, I can help. And now there's cars behind me, and they're all beeping their horns. They're wondering what's taking so long. I roll down my window, and I yell back to them, calm down. I'm trying to give Charlie a little love here. I said, Charlie, I guess there's not much I can do for you. He said, no worries. I said, I wish I could give you a little fun. He said, don't worry about it. I'm gonna take it out on this next person who's been honking their horn. All of a sudden I hear a beep and there's a ticket. I said, thanks, Charlie. I appreciate that. I said, what's gonna happen with this next guy? He said, oh, he'll come up to it. He'll start pushing buttons. And I'll say to him, all you have to do is keep pushing the button, you'll get a ticket. Thanks for being here at Serenity Garage, where we make it all easy. Just keep pushing the button. There won't be a ticket. Just push the button. Keep pushing. Push the button. That's right. Push the button. Keep pushing.
All right, we're back with Paul Richmond, performance poet and spoken word artist, and National Beat Poet Laureate. All right, and Space Monkey for our first Zoom call. This is great. Paul, we are... So listen, we're just running out of time, but I wanted to ask you about, you know, your current... what your vision is for your work and what you're trying to promote through the work you're doing.
First, thanks, Derek, for having me on. Everyone out there is a spoken word artist. The truth matters. Words have power. Trust yourself, the feelings you have. Learn to speak your mind. Have faith in your words and realize how much it can change things. And I hope you get. I hope you've had some sense of that from some of the work you've seen.
Me too. Now, we're going to go to your next video, our final video, which is called It's Not Working. And sort of keeping with our theme of like civilization and its discontents. Anyway, you want to say something quick about it?
This is just me and Tony, and no, same thing, trying to figure out how to take what you might do as a phone call somewhere or whatever's going on. And, you know, this is the state of the world we're in. And keep hope, folks. Yeah, it makes things happen. Can't just ask. You gotta make it.
Gotta do it. All right, here we go. Let's go to the video.
Hello? Hello? Is anybody there? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Is anybody there? Do I have a live person on the line?
Yes, you do, sir. I can hear you loud and clear. What can I do for you?
Finally, I get to talk to somebody. I mean, have you looked out the window lately? Huh? Have you looked out there? I don't think it's working. It's not working for me. I don't think it's working for a lot of people.
What's actually the problem, sir?
I'm trying to tell you, it's not working out there for us.
When did you start feeling this, sir?
I think when I was offered that deal, you know, where you could get 6 for 3. Or maybe it was when I could get 12 for 7. I'm not sure. It always seemed like a deal. But in the end, I'm just in debt. I owe zillions of dollars. It's just not working. I mean, come on. Do the math.
I'm not sure what you're complaining about, sir. This is what everyone does. This is the norm. Everything seems to be working just fine. In fact, I can offer you a deal now. We can give you 20 for 10. We usually don't do that.
I don't want your deals, don't you understand?
Oh, so you don't want to be very cooperative, is that what it is, sir? You know, you should really learn how to cooperate. Because then things would just go along much smoother. If you just did what we wanted you to, it would be a lot easier for you, you know?
It's not my fault. I'm tired of you guys trying to blame me for everything that you're doing. You know what you can do? You can tell those who are doing all this stuff that they can go shove it.
That's not very nice, sir.
I mean, you know, I'm getting tired. I've been on the phone here trying to explain for over an hour.
Sir, you seem to exaggerate. We've only been on for 36 minutes and 40 seconds.
That's it. I've had it. You can go screw yourself. You know what? I'm on a ledge right now, and I'm jumping because of you. What do you think of that, huh? Here I go.
I'm sorry to hear that, sir. We'll make sure we get out a card to your family and send our regards. Yeah, we'll send our regards. We'll send. Our regards.
All right. Hey, hey. That was cool, right? Yeah, no kidding. All right. Thank you so much, Paul Richmond, for coming on the World Fusion Show today. It's been just great to have you and share your, somewhat dystopic vision of the future. The present, actually, is not the future. Hey, we're here. So thanks again.
Bye, movie. Yeah.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
It's really fantastic. All right. Hey, this is Derek Jordan, and thanks for joining us today on the World Fusion Show. It's been just fantastic. We've got lots more fabulous shows coming. Please share with your friends. Join us on Facebook, subscribe on YouTube, and, you know, let's keep spreading this World Fusion thing all over the world. That's right. Yes, we're going to do that. And I'd like to give a shout out to our wonderful sponsors, McKenzie Family Charitable Trust, Dean's Beans, Chris Pratt, Nancy Feinberg, Ron Danz, and Jeff Green. Thank you for your generous support. And remember, as we always say, think globally, listen locally, and support independent music.